thriving in this economy? I mean, yung sa scale na SMB.
I'll have Kendrick answer that, please.
Well, in our experience, there's not a particular business. I think very variety of businesses natin, it's still ongoing. Walang, like, you won't be able to say this, for example, like sabi ka ni sir, online ng puso ngayon. Pero hindi lang siya online. Like, in our experience, like, a lot of our clients are still, may mga traditional businesses pa rin that are still thriving after the pandemic. May mga businesses na nag-start online and then purely online lang, they're still doing well. Narating ko may mga clients na nag-start silang online, then they come to us because now they want to actually open a restaurant. So yung mga nag-start ng catering during the pandemic, yung mga sushi bake, mga ganun, then, you know, they grew their business to the point where malaking following nila. Then now they want to open a physical store or a physical restaurant. So parang walang, like, I won't say that I think yung pinakamasabi lang when it comes to businesses, parang mahirap yung sumusunod na tayo sa trend kasi it has to be something that you're passionate about. Kasi diba, ngayon gusto yung AI, gusto yung modern, pero not necessarily naman lahat dapat pumasok sa ganyang business. Parang it's still about what you know best, what you're passionate about, kasi dun ka mas magta-thrive, especially with the ups and downs ng pagiging entrepreneur. So it's always going to be the challenge. So kung sumusunod ka lang sa trend, kasi mahirap mo sustain yung business pag during the downtime, during the lean time. So, of course, with the help of Esquire, we can help to sustain that there. Pero kung hindi niya rin talaga passion yung business, wala, gusto lang yun. Usually, hindi maglaras talaga yung ganun businesses. So, parang, I won't necessarily say parang there's a particular trend. Maybe may mga no-puso, pero I would still say, parang in our experience, with all the clients we get, wala talagang, like, when people ask us, like, what kind of industries does Esquire support? We really say lahat, eh, kasi yung client base namin, like, every day we get clients coming in, whether they apply online, like, they visit our in the office. Sobrang ibang-iba talaga yung mga businesses, like, one bihira lang yung parang, okay, well, parang pare-pares yung business naman, like, parang hindi ganun. Talagang every day, every client we meet, totally new yung business that we encounter. So, I think, parang hindi masyadong trend, it's really more, I think the biggest trend is more people are getting into business, which is good.
Yes? Hello, Patricia from Business World. You mentioned that Esquire Financing offers non-collateral loans for businesses. So, what are the top reasons businesses apply loans for? Is it like to, you know, improve their infrastructure, or is it to invest in human resources? Like, when they come to you for loans, so what are the reasons they, you know,
so our CEO, Raj, always likes to talk about, you know, the three Ds, so buy, build, and bridge. So the top three reasons why we, you know, like, we support entrepreneurs. And so buy meaning, like, you know, you're buying new equipment, or you're buying, you know, for example, to expand your production, you want to expand your production line, which is very common with the same food businesses. So buying, you know, if you need to buy an equipment, medyo malaki yung capital outlay to be able to sustain yung business or to grow the business. Build, you know, you're building, you know, a commissary, you're expanding your, let's say, your brick and mortar stores, but you're expanding. Then bridges would be, you know, bridge meaning like may mga receivables ka pero matagal yung payment terms, which is pretty common naman here, diba? Let's say you get a customer may order, but you need to actually deliver the product before you actually get the collection. So yung time period na yun, yung crucial na dapat you're still paying your salaries. And all. So yun yung, we, you know, it's called bridge financing. So that's also something we do a lot of. So you may order, may benta, yung collection na yung medyo delayed. So to sustain the business in between, that's what we do.
So since you mentioned yung kanina, sir, yung helping SMEs graduating to become larger businesses. Based on your assessment, sir, how long does it take for an SME to graduate when they're given the right amount of funding?
In Esquire's experience, that can take at least 7 to 10 years. No? Parang mabilis na yun eh. Kasi it's not, like, if you look at the statistics dito sa atin, parang 99% of ano, diba, our MSMEs, micro, small, medium enterprises. Actually, if you look at the thriving economies in Asia, ang laki nung large companies na based in that compared to us, like we actually have like less than 10,000 large companies here. So, and both play a role in the economy. So, kaya part ng advocacy ng chairman namin, our CEO, si Raj, has always been like, he wants to help the SMEs sustain their business but also grow. Not everyone would actually grow into a large company, but his advocacy is really like, we identify companies that have that potential to really grow into being a massive company, to being a large corporation. Kasi, you know, it's good to help the SMEs and to encourage more SMEs, but we also need these SMEs to graduate. You know, like, hindi pwedeng maging parang, like we call it SMEs for now. SME ka lang for now. You know, but we hope that you have that mindset that I'm gonna keep growing. And, you know, it's a mixture of luck, it's a mixture of, you know, timing and all that. Pero if you get to that point where you can grow into becoming, you know, the next PLDTs in San Miguel as of the country, then, you know, kasi lahat naman nag-start as SMEs, but even Jollibee for a corporation, for example. As I remember, my dad used to tell me, he was classmates with Tony Tancampio. So when he was starting out, so, di ba, SME din siya, pero he was able to capture the market and grow into becoming one of the large corporations. That's really the advocacy of S4. We're not just, like, ideally, we don't want our clients to keep coming back to us. And we want them to, you know, come back to us, and then we're seeing the growth in their business. And then we help them get top financing once they get to a certain point, let's say 100 million, then get on, you know, graduate na natin sila to top financing. Para, you know, we use the funds to support other smaller companies.
So yung 7 to 10 years, mabagal ba yun for the industry? How does it compare to other
countries? I think, you know, parang I think that's already, oh, 7 to 10 years, parang unless you're in tech, 7 to 10 years, it's quite fast already for international business. But like I mentioned, Jollibee, you know, it took them probably at least maybe 15 years to get to a point where you can consider them a large corporation. And it's still another, you know, 10, 15 before, you know, like if you look at Jollibee the past 20 years, it has been insane. So I think it's not a fast process unless you're in tech, which is good because we also have a thriving tech startup scene here in the Philippines now. So I think more and more we'll start to see companies grow. And I think it's more of the mindset that the entrepreneurs wanting to really grow to becoming a large company.
I'm just wondering because you mentioned that the biggest trend, Sir Kendrick, is that more Filipinos are getting into businesses, which is great. I wonder, did the pandemic trigger the entrepreneurial spirit of Filipinos?
I think so. Because we sabi nga na parang necessity is the mother of invention. So I think the pandemic, a lot of us were cooped up. Tapos, a lot of people started seeing the opportunity na nalabing mga kailangan ng tao. I think getting into that mindset ng seeing a need and then thinking na, oh, maybe I can fulfill that need. I think that's the parang root of entrepreneurship. So I think a lot of people left the pandemic with that in mind, that in their hearts, even that, oh, I can start pala something, even if it's a small business. So I think definitely the pandemic was a big factor. And also, siguro sabihin na rin natin, diba, like a lot of us, people who were going to the office before the pandemic, naka-experience ng work from home, ay nang bumalik ng corporate work, di ba? So, parang, ano ba ibang option? So maybe I should start a business. And I think that, and, you know, like, during the pandemic, you know, marami rin hosting mga webinars, like, sabi nga, drinks, di ba? Like, mga online events. So, I think people got started, you know, got into that rabbit hole of learning about entrepreneurship. I think it's one of those things that once you get a taste of it, mahirap na ma-shut off. You want to keep trying, starting something.